Disaster recovery refers to the policies and procedures related to preparing for recovery or continuation of Appian systems after an entire environment suffers a catastrophic failure, referred to as a major incident. A site may be brought offline by flooding, fire, other natural disasters, or power outages where no backup power is available. If the site running your primary instance of Appian suffers a major incident and is brought offline, a recovery site in a geographically separate location is started up, with backed up data from the primary site. Users accessing Appian systems are redirected to the recovery site. Self-managed customers, those who maintain their own Appian servers, need to create a disaster recovery plan and furnish the necessary infrastructure in case of a major incident. Appian Cloud customers will coordinate with Appian on disaster recovery requirements, and Appian will handle all disaster recovery infrastructure. Disaster recovery should not be confused with high availability. Highly available systems are configured such that if one server goes offline, users are rerouted to another server running the same services that has access to the same data. High availability is designed to limit interruptions to users' access to Appian systems in the event of hardware or software failure on a server. Disaster recovery is for when an entire site becomes unavailable and a new site must be started up. When starting up a recovery site, Appian must load data from backups of the primary site. Any data not backed up will be lost. The amount of data that you can tolerate to lose is called the recovery point objective, or RPO, and determines how frequently you need to back up your data. For instance, if you can tolerate losing 1 day's worth of data, then your RPO is 1 day, and you should back up your data nightly. However, if you can only lose an hour's worth of data, you'll have to perform backups every hour. Another consideration when planning for disaster recovery is how long it takes a recovery site to start up. The recovery time objective, or RTO, refers to how long you can wait after your primary site becomes unavailable before your recovery site is fully started. When starting up a recovery site, all transactions in the Kafka transaction log will need to be replayed. One way to reduce the time it takes to replay the transaction log is checkpointing. Checkpointing is a process by which entries from the transaction log are written to persistent files called KDB files. These files are then backed up along with your file system. In the event of a major incident, the only transactions that will need to be replayed at the recovery site are those that occurred after the last checkpoint. You need to back up 3 categories of data in order to later start up a recovery site: the data stored in all relational databases, Appian components on your server file system, and your internal messaging service. Your databases and file system can be backed up using industry-standard backup methods and replication tools. Appian does not recommend any one tool or technique for backing up your databases and file system. Regardless of which method is used, make sure you back up the data stored in the directories listed in the Appian documentation. The internal messaging service is backed up using Apache's Kafka Mirror Maker solution. This open-source solution is a continuously running process that backs up data on a transaction-by-transaction basis. Mirror Maker requires that Appian be installed and that the internal messaging service be running in your recovery environment. When the primary site is running normally, the chosen backup solutions for the file system and databases will write data to your recovery site at a frequency determined by your RPO. The internal messages will be backed up continuously as new transactions are created. The systems running on the recovery site are determined by your RTO. Having more systems running will lower downtime, but will consume more resources. In the event of a major incident, say a flood at the primary site, the recovery site is started up, loaded with backed up data, and any non-checkpointed transactions are replayed. Finally, user traffic is rerouted to the recovery site, where users can restart their sessions. The Appian documentation contains more information on disaster recovery configuration and requirements. Go to docs.appian.com and search for disaster recovery to learn more and keep your data safe in the event of a major incident.